la carne, e la neve immacolato ucciso Cristo, come racconta il Cilano. Nella notte santa di Grecia, Francesco, tale diacono,
Francis arranged for mass to be celebrated on the manger that stood between the ox and the ass. Later, an altar was built over this manger, so that where animals had once fed on hay, men could now receive the flesh of the spotless Lamb, Jesus Christ, for the salvation of soul and body, as Thomas of Celano tells us. Francis himself, as a deacon, had sung the Christmas Gospel on the holy night in Greccio with resounding voice. Through the friar's radiant Christmas singing, the whole celebration seemed to be a great outburst of joy. It was the encounter with God's humility that caused this joy. His goodness creates the true feast.
È stato in gran parte murato. È rimasta soltanto una bassa apertura di un metro e mezzo. L'intenzione era probabilmente di proteggere meglio la chiesa dagli assalti, ma soprattutto di evitare che si entrasse a cavallo nella casa di Dio. Chi desidera entrare nel luogo della nascita di Gesù deve chinarsi. Mi sembra che ciò.
Anyone wishing to enter the Church of Jesus' Nativity in Bethlehem will find that the doorway 5.5 meters high, through which emperors used to enter the building, is now largely walled up. Only a low opening of 1.5 meters has remained. The intention was probably to provide the church with better protection from attack, but above all, to prevent people from entering God's house on horseback. Anyone wishing to enter the place of Jesus' birth has to bend down. It seems to me that a deeper truth is revealed here, which should touch our hearts on this holy night. If we want to find the God who appeared as a child, then we must dismount from the high horse of our enlightened reason. We must set aside our false certainties, our intellectual pride, which prevents us from recognizing God's closeness. We must follow the interior path of Saint Francis, the path leading to that ultimate outward and inward simplicity which enables the heart to see. We must bend down spiritually. We must, as it were, go on foot in order to pass through the portal of faith and encounter the God who is so different from our prejudices and opinions, the God who conceals himself in the humility of a newborn baby. In this spirit, let us celebrate the liturgy of the Holy Night. Let us strip away our fixation on what is material, on what can be measured and grasped. Let us allow ourselves to be made simple by the God who reveals himself to the simple of heart.